con la entrevista a Stefan Wilkeman, el presidente y CEO de Lamborghini Automobili Lamborghini.
Well, Stefan, thank you very much for having us here in Ascari, in the south of Spain, for this the launch of the new Huracán. I had the pleasure of being with you guys in Vegas, I think, Tenerife, Miami, and now here. So thank you very much for that.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Lamborghini, it's been quite a good time in the past decade, let's say, right? Like a lot of evolution, a lot of good things coming out, even though in that decade include like the biggest recession in the history of the U.S. and pretty much around the world.
Yes, I think that we worked on pretty everything which you can work on a car brand. So we did a lot of things around the brand, increasing awareness and image, which is including the CICD, all what is to do with the PR activities. We were concentrated on giving always the same message about our super sports cars. We implemented and we executed the two model strategy with all the derivatives. We launched the one-off idea of having very exclusive single cars. And last but not least, we worked a lot inside our headquarters to increase the professionality, the amount of people, and also in terms of our worldwide dealer network, we more than doubled it in the last decade.
Yeah, and it's been that vision recognized not only by like other companies that monitor the auto industry, but also like people who really want to come and work for Lamborghini. I just saw a report that there's one of the most sought companies to work in Italy.
Yes, this is one of the positive signs that beside let's say our attitude internally, this is also perceived outside, and it's clear that it's sexy to work for a company like Lamborghini, which is in the luxury business, which is let's say producing the best super sports cars. But it's also a sign that there is a lot of work that we did with the schools, with the university, to attract people, and this also together with the mouse propaganda of seeing that we are a good place to work in every sense.
Yeah, and you also put your words where your efforts where the your words are, like you're reinvesting a lot of money into your facilities, into your like programs to develop more people and then to attract the best people possible, because at the end you want to put out the best product possible too, right?
Right, so it's a combination. You need to reinvest to keep the dream alive, and on the other hand, you need the right people, which are not only the best professionals that you can get, but they also have to feel the passion about the brand, and they need to have the willingness to engage for Lamborghini.
Well, and following like a great leader like you, it's a little bit easier, I guess, for everybody who works at Lamborghini, no?
Well, thank you for the leader, but it's a teamwork in this sense, and everybody is part of the family and represents Lamborghini. And I think this is also what you feel when you come to our events.
No, absolutely, yeah. It's a very friendly environment, even though a Lamborghini can be to some people a little bit intimidating in terms of being like a very powerful car and exclusive, but you really feel that kind of family atmosphere around here.
Yes, and once you drive the car, you also feel, and especially with the Huracán, that it's a very easy to drive and daily drivable car. And what we wanted to achieve is really to have the maximum of the range, to have an easiness of the road, but also a very good performance on the race.
Yeah, so you want us to be part of the family. Yeah. So speaking of which, it's a very exclusive car, all your cars are, but Lamborghini is kind of expanding to other kind of merchandise, like fashion and like perfumes and all those kind of things to maybe attract people in other ways than just like not buying the cars, right?
Yes, because what we're doing is clearly we are 99.9% is about developing, producing and selling our cars. But we have one thing, which is our Collezione Automobili Lamborghini, which is about collection of which goes from car models, but also into fashion and things like this. And this is the only thing we do because there are two reasons. The first one is it's not diluting the values of the brand. And on the other side, it's attracting people into the world of Lamborghini, and it's also a good business case for us. Yeah.
So the economy has recuperated more or less in the U.S. in some other parts of the country. You're growing big in some other markets like China, and even though it's other smaller markets like South America, Brazil, Chile, but a lot more people are feeling comfortable of getting a Lamborghini and driving it around every day.
Yes, for sure. The fact that the last years we worked a lot on the attractiveness, not only on the, of the brand, but also on the cars, is now giving us an easy access to a larger crowd of people, and also thanks to the bigger car park, because we are a very small company, and in the 50 plus 1 years they were produced around 30,000 cars only, and if the half of them are still on the street, then it's a lot. So we are still a very, very small company, but awareness and image increased dramatically in the last decade.
Well, thank you very much for your time and having us here. And I really like that mantra that you have a century of development in half the time, right?
Yeah, no, 100 years of innovation in half the time.
Excellent. Thank you very much. And we're going to go and enjoy the car more in the track here. Thank you.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.